I hope you and your loved ones are staying safe and healthy during the COVID-19 pandemic. The pandemic has altered many aspects of our daily lives, and many pre-med students had their MCAT test dates canceled. A few days ago, the American Association of Medical Colleges, which writes the MCAT exam, released an update regarding testing for the year of 2020. In this video, I'll cover the update and how it'll affect you. Hi everyone, I'm Vikram Shah, MCAT expert and 528 scorer. Many of you likely have questions about the updated 2020 MCAT. How long is the shortened exam? How do I study for the new exam? And what do I do if my test date was canceled? Don't worry, we have you covered. First, we'll go over the changes that affect all pre-meds taking the MCAT in 2020. Next, we'll go over what to do if you had a test date that was canceled. And finally, we'll cover what to do if you are a student with a test date on the updated 2020 MCAT calendar. Let's dive right in. First, let's look at the changes that'll affect all pre-med students taking the MCAT in 2020 and how to approach the unique challenges that they present. Update number one, the MCAT has been temporarily shortened in length to 5 hours and 45 minutes instead of the normal 7 hours and 33 minutes. The chemistry, physics, biology, biochemistry, and psychology, sociology sections will have 48 questions to answer in 76 minutes instead of the normal 59 questions in 95 minutes. The shortened cars section will contain 48 questions to answer in 81 minutes instead of the normal 53 questions in 90 minutes. This altered format raises a few questions. Which questions is the AAMC going to remove? How will the shortened exam be scored? And how should I study for the updated version of the exam? Let's dive into each of these questions. First, which questions is the AAMC going to remove? The test maker stated that they are going to remove experimental questions, which tend to be questions that they have not used on exams before. Keep in mind that the exam is scaled, meaning you're compared to how your peers perform. If the shortened exam is easier because they had removed a few hard questions, the grading of the exam will be harder. The exam was also made shorter by altering the break structure. The mid-exam break that was traditionally a 30-minute lunch break will now shorten to only 10 minutes. How will the shortened exam be scored? The shortened exam will be scored in the exact same way as the full-length MCAT, where you receive a score between 118 and 132 on each of the four sections and a score between 472 and 528 on the entire exam. Again, however, you'll be compared to your peers. If the exam is harder, you can miss more questions to achieve a high score. On the other hand, if the exam is easier, you'll need to miss fewer questions to achieve a high score. So, how should I study for the updated version of the exam? To study for this updated version of the exam, ensure that you are comfortable and confident with your timing strategies. For chemistry and physics, biology, biochem, and psychology and sociology passages, you should still spend 8 minutes per passage and 1 minute per standalone question. For CARS passages, you should still spend 10 minutes per passage. When you take practice full-length exams that are not shortened, such as the practice full-lengths provided by the AAMC, you should take the entire full-length exam as if it were your real test. By training your endurance to handle a 7-hour and 33-minute exam, a 5-hour and 45-minute exam will feel a lot easier. Many track runners use the same technique. They run an average of 15 miles per day during peak training weeks to build up aerobic capacity up to 15 miles, even though the longest race they might run is actually 10 miles. Update number two. This change regards the time you take your test. Students will be assigned one of the three testing times on the calendar day that they are taking the MCAT: 6:30 a.m., 12:15 p.m., or 6 p.m. This is obviously big news, and the best way to practice for this change is to take your practice exams at the time you have been assigned. All test dates in the 2020 calendar will follow the three tests per day format, so these times will apply to every student taking the exam during the remaining test dates in 2020. If you are a registered student with an 8 a.m. start time, you will be reassigned a new start time for your MCAT prior to the opening of registration on May 7th, according to the news released by the AAMC. Update number three. Three new MCAT test dates have been opened up: June 28th, September 28th, and September 29th. Registration for these test dates will open on May 7th, and if you need to sign up for an MCAT in 2020, you will likely need to sign up on May 7th as the spots will probably go extremely quickly. Update number four. All rescheduling fees have been temporarily waived by the AAMC. Update number 5. MCAT scores for exams taken between June 19th and August 1st will be released in an expedited manner. Students should know their score 2 weeks after they have taken the exam instead of the usual 4 weeks. This will help students who are applying to medical schools for the 2020-2021 application cycle. Your primary application can be submitted and processed without an MCAT score, but schools only give interview invites once they have received an MCAT score and secondary application. Medical schools are aware of the changes in MCAT testing caused by the coronavirus pandemic, and to stay up to date with how the medical schools are handling these changes, please visit the AAMC website or call an individual medical school. Update number 6. The first transmission deadline to medical schools has been delayed by 2 weeks, so schools will now receive the first applications submitted to AMCAS on July 10th. Medical schools are aware of the MCAT delays and are working with the AAMC to provide flexibility in the 2020-2021 application cycle review process. Update number 7. Social distancing procedures will be in place at the Pearson View testing centers. MCAT testers will be placed 6 feet apart. They can wear masks and gloves to the testing center, and hand sanitizer will be available. Now that we've covered the changes that will affect every pre-med student taking the MCAT in 2020, let's look at what to do if you had a test date that was canceled. Action item 1. Frequently check the AAMC COVID-19 page or follow the AAMC Twitter page for updates. Action item 2. Mark May 7th in your calendar and set multiple reminders on your cell phone as the date on which 2020 MCAT registration opens. Spots may fill up quickly, so it is important that you are timely and sign up for a 2020 test date at that time. If you need to see what MCAT dates are available for 2020, we have the updated complete list of dates available on our website. The link is in the description below. Finally, let's talk about what you should do if you have a test date on the updated 2020 MCAT calendar. Action item 1. Make sure to check your email to ensure a cancellation notice has not been sent to you by your test center. Action item 2. If you're ever unsure about the status of your exam, you should call your testing center. Action item 3. If you'd like to change test dates, you'll need to register for a new test date on May 7th, but there's no guarantee that you'll get a new test date. So if you're okay with your current test date, you're better off sticking with it. Action item 4. You should get an email soon indicating which of the 3 exam start times you've been assigned. I hope this video gave you some clarity as we navigate these uncertain times together. Please feel free to leave any questions in the comments section below and we'll respond within 24 hours. As always, if you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos. And if you'd like to receive a free MCAT question of the day so you can get in every last bit of practice before test day, click the link in the description below. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.